the farmers around here have been deep ripping for many years. Now we're going back and re-ripping for second, third, fourth, fifth time with different machinery. Our machinery has progressed over the years, and that is all about getting highly alkaline surface soil down deeper in the profile and addressing our subsoil acidity, and at the same time managing compaction to greater depths. The growers we're looking at here today all implement their ripping strategy slightly differently, all aiming to achieve the same end result. And I think it proves how there's no right and wrong way to do it, but they've all come up with a strategy that fits their own individual machinery configuration and business structure.
The ripper we've got behind me is a Gessner. It's Australian made. I was able to custom make this particular ripper to suit our farm. The beauty of this one and what we asked in our custom build is we wanted a 800 mil roller at the back. We wanted a roller that continually presses down on the ground to give us a finish that there's no soil blow, soil erosion.
The type of machine that we have is a bedner. We need to put a bit more clay into our soil. Bring the clay to the surface gives you more water retention and just holds the moisture higher in the soil. So the bedner actually has got these clay blades that bring clay up.
Paul, on the other hand, has put the delving plates on the Gessner. I think it's one of the first Gessners set up with delving plates.
This particular farm is new to us. We felt there was an established hard pan down at 300, 400 mil. So what we did was, as well as trying to put our tram lining system in place, we felt that we need to cross rip. So what we did was the first year, we ripped on a 45 to our tram. 2 years later, we reversed or moved that ripping line 90 degrees. So again, 45 to our tram. And what it's done for us and what we can see today is that it's actually fracked the soil in multiple directions. A, this way, B, this way, and our seeding straight ahead. The roller not only smooths out the soil or any clay lumps, it does a slight incorporation of the soil at the surface, smooths it out, it gives it a good soil bed for your seeder to go through the following year. This is why we rip pre-canola seeding. Canola is absolutely essential as far as seed soil contact, as your depths are so finite, we're talking 10 to 15 mil or 0 to 15 mil in some cases. So therefore you need a particular type of surface, otherwise what you'll be doing is hamstringing your next season's crop.
We rip at 15 degrees of what we seed at, and then we go across 15 degrees the other way. So it gives you a 30 degree variance. With our cross ripping, it's a lot easier to do your spraying and your seeding because you're actually not going with the ripping lines, you're actually going across them, and it kind of keeps you on top of it instead of running in those lines, which is pretty hard to do. With the re-ripping, it just makes things softer, and that's what we're trying to do. We're trying to make it as softer as we can, so it's easier for the plant to get through the soil and out, and also to get to the depth where the moisture is.
Every soil is slightly different as to how often we have to re-rip it, and there's a number of different reasons for that, but re-ripping is going to be always required, but the frequency will change depending on how you manage those soils and your machinery configuration and the amount of clay you've got in your soil. The higher the clay content, the less frequently we have to rip. The lower the clay content, the more frequently and the deeper we have to rip.
We've worked out that re-ripping would be, it's cost efficient every 4 years, except in the situation when there's a new farm, then we would say the benefit will be multiplied by doing it biannually. There's a huge cost to ripping, but there's a bigger cost not to rip. And that's the balance. Machines aren't getting any cheaper, fuel's not getting any cheaper, but there is still a perfect cost-benefit balance every 4 years.
With the re-ripping, nothing's ever set in stone of how we do it. We've got two rippers and we do different things in different paddocks. No one's ever right, no one's ever wrong.